Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shubhangi. Today I am going to make this beautiful set of coasters. I bought these coasters from a vendor and then I painted it and did the varnish. This is absolutely safe for putting any hot mug over it. And it looks absolutely amazing with this glossy finish. Friends, if you are new to my channel, please do take time to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon to get the regular notification. And also follow us on Facebook and Instagram to know more about me and my work. So let's get started. So friends, the things that are needed for making this coaster set are Shunya's toolkit for making smaller and bigger dots. You also need this MDF coaster set. Coaster set has this extra part where you can pour the resin. Friends, at first I have painted this coaster set with black color and let it dry for a while. As this coaster is a hexagonal shape, so I am just joining all the sides of the coaster so that you can easily find the center of it. And this will also help in making the guidelines. Let's start with design number one. Friends, at first I am making a bigger dot using the bamboo tool. I am using a violet color here. And then I am surrounding this dot with very tiny dots. I am just making tiny dots with the lemon yellow color. And then I am filling up the gap between them. So you can use your finest dotting tool for making this, and you have to dip your tool once and then you can make these tiny dots. Friends, now I am surrounding these yellow color dots with the same violet color that I have done on the center part. So make sure you do not increase the size of the tool. You just have to use the same tool and make the dots between the two dots of the previous rows. Friends, now for the third row, I am using the white color or pearl white color, either you can use, and with a slightly bigger dotting tool, you have to make a slightly bigger dots between the dots of the previous row. So you have to dip your tool and then you have to make each dot. These paints that I'm using here are acrylic paint. I'll mention all about these paints in the description. So please don't miss to read about the paint and other details about the tools and everything. So friends, now for the next row, I'm using lemon yellow color again. And I'm dipping my tool into the paint and making the dots slightly bigger than the previous row dots. And as you can see how beautiful the contrast of violet and yellow appears here. So now I'm just following up the guidelines and making some bigger bamboo tool dots. Friends, now you have to make the petal shape structure. So all you have to do is dip your tool into the paint. Here I'm using the white color and then I'm making the dot from the outer edge of the bigger dot and then moving towards the bottom of it. So in this way, the size of the dots will keep on decreasing from the top of the bigger dot to the bottom, and it will give a beautiful petal shape structure, just like a petal of a flower. Friends, make sure you do not dip your tool too many times. You just have to dip it once and move from top to bottom. So friends, for the next layer, I'm using the same lemon yellow acrylic paint, and in the same technique as we have done before with the white color in the first row, we have to dip our tool once and then move from the outer edge of the bigger dot towards the bottom, and with as you move from top to bottom, the size of the dot will keep on decreasing, giving a beautiful petal shape structure. Friends, now I am moving to the next row in which I am using the same violet color. And I am doing the same technique as I've done before, but here just make sure with each layer of the petal you have to keep on increasing the size of the tool. So here you can see that my tool is making slightly bigger dots than the previous rows, and just as we have done before, starting up with the outer edge of the bigger dot to the bottom of it. So friends, for the next row, I'm making slightly bigger dots at the outer edge of these petals using the white color. And then I'm again doing the same pattern as we have done before, making the same petal shape structure, starting up from the outer edge and then moving towards the bottom of the row. When I'm using dark color and I'm also using white with the so I always finish up my pattern with the lighter shade because it gives a beautiful contrast border to it, and it gives it defines the edges. So I am just ending up with a white color petal, and then I am making some swirls between these petals. So I am making a dot and then dragging the dot using the same dotting tool. You can either make a dot and use a finer dotting tool, but I am using the same tool here, and then I'm finishing up with the top dot, and I'm making lemon yellow color dots over the purple color or violet color bigger dots. I felt like there is some gap between the petals, so I just made single bigger dots between these yellow swirls. And it is now done. Let's start up with design number 2. Friends, here I'm starting up with the same bamboo tool using the green color. And then I'm making some tiny dots surrounding this green color using my fine dotting tool. At first I'm dotting over the guidelines and then filling up the gap between them. You can make 2 dots or 3 dots depending upon the space. So friends, for the second row, I'm using lemon yellow color, and using the same dotting tool, I'm making the dots between the dots of the previous row. Following this technique, this mandala will become very, very compact, and there is very less space, yet a beautiful fine space between them. So for the third row, I'm using the violet color. As the same violet color that we have done in the first coaster. So using a slightly bigger dotting tool, I am making the dots between the 2 dots of the previous row. And for the next row, I am using this magenta color or a slightly darker shade of pink. And I am making the dots between the 2 dots of the previous row. And these dots are slightly bigger than the dots that I have done before. So friends, now I'm moving on to the next row, in which I'm using this beautiful bright green color. So you can use a grass green color or your regular green color. And then I'm moving to the next row with the white color or pearl white color. So you have to use the same bamboo tool. Don't use a very big size of bamboo tool here. Try to increase the size of the tools very slowly. Don't just move on to from a very fine tool to a very bigger tool. In that case, the size, the shape of the mandala will not be as beautiful as it has to be, and there will be a big space between them. So we don't want that bigger space between the dots. So friends, now I am moving to the next row using the lemon yellow color and making the dots with slightly bigger dots. Let me know in the comment section if you want me to make all my designs with very fine guidelines. If you are a beginner, so I can do that for you. I can make some designs with too many guidelines. That might help you in making a very, very beautiful symmetrical mandala. But normally I do it freehand, so as of now I am using a very less guidelines. So as you can see, for the next row I'm using a slightly bigger bamboo tool and making the dots using the violet color. So friends, as you can see, there is a slight gap between these purple color, violet color dots. So I thought of making some fine straight lines using the dotting tool. So I'm using the same magenta color that I have done before in the fourth row. You can use pink or magenta color, whatever is there with you. So you have to dip your tool into the paint and from the bottom to the top, just make some fine dots. And then I am just filling up the gap between the yellow dots, making some tiny dots with white color or pearl white color. So these are some fine techniques that you can use whenever you make any design, and if you feel that there is too much gap between the dots, so you can just make two dots, or you can make multiple dots depending upon the space. So you can make these dots and it will just fill up the space. So for the inner white color row, I'm using this pink color or magenta color dots between the space, and I think I would just do some top dots over the purple color dots. I'm using green color here to make the top dots. I would suggest you to just let it dry for a while and then do the top dots, because sometimes the dots are not very well defined. But as I'm making this video and I wanted to do it in one go, so I'm just doing it now. And similarly for the yellow color, I'm using this pink color top dots. You can just drop that dot, the top dot. I'm just dropping up some paint over it. You can do that. You can also use a brush to do the top dots. That is also very convenient. Or if you want to use the tool only and just use your technique how you make the dots, then you have to wait till the first layer is completely dry. Friends, for the white color dots, I'm using this purple color top dots, and I'm using my finer dotting tool because I wanted some very tiny top dot. I don't want the purple color to overdo, and I wanted the white color to be properly visible. So I'm making very very small dot here. So friends, now the second design is also done, and this is a very simple design, yet it looks very pretty with the beautiful colors. So these two designs are done now. Let's start off with design number three. For this next design, I'm starting up with the cerulean blue color, and I'm making a tiny white color dots and then filling up the gap between them, following up the guidelines. So you can make two dots or three dots depending upon the space between these dots. And then for the next row, I'm using orange color tiny dots. As we have done before, you have to make the dots between the two dots of the previous row. And then I'm following up with the same blue color that I have done the center with. So friends, my center part is done, and then I'm proceeding to the making the petal shape structure, and then I'm using here the orange color slightly bigger dots. And then again I'm making the petal shape structure using the blue color, and I'm dipping my tool into the paint, and from the outer edge I am making a dot and proceeding towards the bottom of it. So these are like very small petals because the center dot is smaller. Friends, now I'm doing the reverse pattern, in which I'm starting up from the bottom and then proceeding towards the top. And you just have to follow the petal of the first row. And so the first row will help you in making the shape. and it has to be slightly curved, and the size of the dots has to be like decreasing from bottom to top this time. Friends, now I am doing the same pattern, and but I'm using a different orange color here, and that is we are just starting off with the bottom and moving towards the top, and look how beautiful this pattern is coming up. It is very, very effortless, and believe me, you will just love it when you make it, because this is very, very different design than usually what we do. So for the next row, I'm just following up the shape that is coming up organically. You don't have to draw it through a pencil. You just have to go with the flow. And I'm using this beautiful bright blue color here. So for the next row, I'm using the same white color. So I have used only three colors here. So you can see how with a very minimal use of colors, you can make beautiful mandala. You don't have to use too many colors. You just have to know the exact amount of color and the contrast, the color pattern that will look beautiful together. So I am just moving on with the top dots. I'm using this white color for making the top dots here, and I'm done with this design. I'm really happy to share my fourth design now. Friends, for the next design, I'm starting off with black color center, and then I'm surrounding it with the crimson red color. I'm making a cross shaped structure, and then I'm filling up the gap between them. You can also follow the guidelines and then make the dots. And then I am making the same red color dots again. All you have to do is make the dots between the two dots of the previous row. And then I'm mixing a few drops of lemon yellow color into my red color. And you can see how beautiful this color will change into slightly orangish reddish color. And thus for the next row, I'm using that paint and making the dots between the two dots of the previous row. You just have to make the dots here. You don't have to follow too many patterns. I'm just making a very basic mandala. So now I'm mixing slight red a small drop of red color to my orange color, and then I'm proceeding with the same color. Try to use a slightly bigger dotting tool here than you have done in the previous row. Then I'm mixing the yellow color here to this orange color. You can either add a few drops of yellow, or you can use a bigger amount of yellow. Depends on how the color shading are you looking for. So I'm not looking for a drastic change in the color shade. So I'm just adding few drops of yellow, and look how beautiful this is coming up. I'm not sure if this is looking exactly in the video, but in the real the shade is coming up really, really beautiful. So for each row, you just have to add a few drops of yellow and keep on going. And then again, adding few more drops of lemon yellow color to the paint that you have made. You can just proceed to the next row. I'm using my smaller dotting tool here. This is not the fine dotting tool, this is the bamboo tool, but the smaller size. So for the next and the last row, I've added a little more yellow color so that it becomes more yellow, not the orangish yellow. And this is how I am ending up the last row. I'm making some tiny orange color or red color. You can also use red color, but I'm using the leftover orange color paint, and this is now done. Look how beautiful this is looking now. This looks like a sunset to me. I absolutely love orange shades. Let's start off with design number 5. So friends, I'm starting up with the black color center dot, and then I am surrounding this black color dots with the crimson red color. I'm just making the dots on the guidelines and then filling up the gap between them using my finer dotting tool. So for the next row, I'm using the orange color. You can use the leftover orange color from the previous design, or you can use a fresh orange as well. So I'm using my fine dotting tool here again. So for the next row, I'm using lemon yellow color. And now I think many of you can guess what will be the next row. I think you can guess now. Let me know in the comment section. Yes, you are absolutely right. This is green color. So we are making a rainbow here. So I'm using this bright, beautiful green color, slightly bigger dot. I'm using my tiny bamboo tool here and dipping my tool into the paint and making each dots. So the next row is blue color. So I'm using cerulean blue color here. You can use any bright blue that you have. And then I am moving to the indigo blue color. This is the ultramarine blue, the shade that I have used. And I've used this Fevicryl acrylic paint here. And again, for the next row, I'm using violet color and a slightly bigger bamboo tool that I have used here. Dipping my tool into the paint and making each dot between the two dots of the previous row. Friends, now I'm finishing this up with the golden color dots. I'm making some dots and then dragging it from top to bottom and making this tiny swirls. As I think there was a slightly more space, I would have used a bigger tool, but as I used a smaller tool, so there's a space, so this is what I did. So this is the design and it looks absolutely beautiful. So let's start off with the last design, number 6. Friends, I'm starting off with the black color center dots using the bamboo tool, the bigger bamboo tool. And then I'm making this spiral design, and so I'll be using two colors. I'm alternatively making dots with blue and orange color. So this is how I did: blue, orange, blue, orange, blue, orange. And then I did some tiny orange dots between blue and orange, leaving a small space between them, in which I later on filled this blue color. So now you can see how I'm filling up the gap with the blue color. And then I'm again making dots between the blue, orange. And then the leftover space, I filled it up with blue color. So it might look very tricky, but believe me, this is a very, very easy design. So again, I have made the orange color dots between the orange and blue. And you will just have to leave the space, and in which you will fill up this blue color again. And now you can see how this small spiral is already made here. And then I'll proceed up to the orange color again, and then filling it up with the blue color between the spaces left. Again, I'm making a bigger orange color dot. So with each row, you have to also increase the size of your tool. So here I'm using my bamboo tool, and with the same size of tool, you don't have to change the size with the orange and blue in the same row. So with the same tool, I'm making this blue color, and now with the slightly bigger bamboo tool, or maybe with the same size of bamboo tool, I'm making the orange color dots between blue and orange. And then later on, I added up this pearl white color top dots, and this design is done. So friends, you don't have to make the blue color row in the last row, so it will look like a star shaped spiral. If you want to make it a round shaped spiral, then you can fill it up with blue color. So this is how all the six design look up after it is completely done. So friends, with this measuring or weighing machine, you can say, I'm just checking up the weight of this mixing bowl. So it is like 25 grams. So now I'm adding my resin to it, and you can see how this is moving. So I just decided to add 30 grams of this resin, and then 10 grams of hardener. So from 25 to 55 is our resin part, and then I'm adding 10 grams of hardener to it. Friends, I'm using this silicone mixing bowl, so I try not to use too many plastic mugs. And this is just a single bowl that I am mixing both the silicone and the hardener to it. And then I am mixing it up with my spatula. This is also made of silicone, so it is very, very easy to clean it later. So I have mixed it properly, and I am now pouring it up onto the coasters, and this is how I'm pouring it. And as you can see, in these coasters there are this defined edges, so you don't have to worry about the flowing of the resin at the back of the coaster, but you can seal it up with masking tape if you are worried about dropping off this resin at the back. So you just pour it and cover all the edges of this coaster. I've made a separate video for how I pour resin on my art. I'll just attach the video on the I button. And with my mixing spatula, I'm just spreading a very thin layer of the resin on this outer frame, so that it will also get completely sealed with the resin. If you want, you can flow it up completely, but I prefer just a thin layer of resin over it. And in the similar way, I'm pouring the resin on all of them. So friends, this is my new gadget that I have recently purchased. This was a barbecue lighter, and it has this on and off lock button, and you can also regulate the amount of gas that you want to come out. And through this button, you can on the lighter, and there is a flame of fire that is coming out, and through which you can pop up all the bubbles that are coming up from the resin. As you can see in the video, I'm just popping up all the bubbles, and this is becoming coming up very crystal clear. And this is very, very handy and very easy to operate, and plus safer option for the people who are having kids or pets at home, and you don't want the bigger lighter or that blowtorch with the butane gas, or I don't know what kind of gas is that. I'm not very sure about the gas. So you can use this lighter, and I'll share the link about this in my description. So don't forget to check the description below. And you can see how the resin appears after this. It is very, very easy to use, and I absolutely love it. So friends, my coasters are ready after 24 hours. As this is winter, so it might take long. So it was little longer than 24 hours, but it is completely dry now. And they are absolutely safe for putting any hot or cold object over it. I always prefer doing resin on my coasters or placemat. But you can do varnish, but for me, resin is always a safer option. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel. And if you have already subscribed and following my work since many months or years, then please do share and support my channel. This is how you can support me for making more such videos. Take care. Bye bye.